the Rubik's Cube. For some, it's a mysterious puzzle. For others, it's a way to show their dexterity and prowess. But for us, it's a tool. A tool to understand one of the most abstract concepts in mathematics, groups. But before that, we need to understand what actually makes up a Rubik's Cube.
The Rubik's Cube isn't actually made of 27 little cubes. It's made up of three parts. Corners, which are cubies with three stickers, edges, which are cubies with two stickers, and the center, which rotates around an axis. The first thing we're going to need to clarify is face notation. This is going to be the F face, this is going to be the R face, and this is going to be the U face. Now, what is a group? A group is just a set of objects under an operator. In this case, the set of objects is all of the 43 quintillion different permutations of the Rubik's Cube, and the operator is just chaining two of these moves together to get another. We're going to call this group the Rubik's group. One major property of all groups is closure. Just like adding two integers gives you another integer, chaining two permutations gives you another permutation within the group. The second property of groups is the existence of an identity element, which does nothing when operated on, just like adding 0 or multiplying by 1. Property 3, inverse. Every move has an inverse, but when you chain moves, it becomes a bit more complex. When you chain two moves together, such as U and R, to invert it, you move backwards, doing the inverse of R and then the inverse of U, in a sense retracing your steps back to the identity element. One clarification to make is that groups do not need to be commutative, so reordering doesn't have to be the same. Focus on the way this QB ends up after these two moves. Now see where it ends up when I reorder the moves. It ends up here. Commutative groups are called abelian groups, and non-commutative groups are called non-abelian groups. Pause. Okay, while groups don't have to be commutative, they do have to be associative. What does that mean? Well, just like how when you add three numbers, it doesn't matter where you place the parentheses, as long as the order of the moves are the same, you will get the same result. In essence, the Rubik's Cube is not just a puzzle. It's a tangible example of group theory in action, showcasing permutation and symmetry within mathematical groups. So, whether solved in seconds or pondered over for hours, the Rubik's Cube remains a timeless emblem of the elegant interplay between mathematics and play.